you count on. NBC2 News at 5:30.
Neighbors in Cape Coral are upset after a yacht crashed into their dock. Turns out this yacht had been dumped after it was struck by lightning and burned. You might remember a few months ago, we showed you the boat on fire in Cape Coral, and now that same 60-foot yacht is having more problems.
Only NBC2's Gina Tomlinson is bringing you this story. She joins us now from Cape Coral to explain what's going on.
Well, we were inside watching some March Madness, and we heard the neighbors yelling, "Hey, John," who's my uncle, "somebody's about to hit your boat." And we got up, we ran down here, and sure enough, there was a boat floating backwards down the canal.
Suddenly, Kevin Walter was watching Madness in real life Friday night. This 60-foot yacht creating chaos, slamming into docks and boats in the canal off Southwest 58th Street around 8 p.m. In an exclusive video from a neighbor, you can see it was being pulled by three people in a smaller fishing boat appearing to lose control.
There were no lights on it or anything. We actually couldn't even see it very well until we took a flashlight and shined on it, at which point we realized that it had been burnt to a crisp.
Turns out this is the same boat we showed you in January, catching fire after a lightning strike. Saturday morning, other boaters captured photos showing the yacht abandoned in the water by Glover Bight Bay. Then the massive burnt boat floated back into the canal near Turpin Estates Road. Neighbors there were able to tie it up to a dock, and it was pulled out of the water this morning by sea tow. The owner of the boat, called Nomas, told me this whole thing happened after he turned over the ownership to his insurance company. He's in Texas right now, so we talked over the phone.
But I was assured that the boat would be secure, that would be moved, would be followed up and taken out of the water and salvaged. I'm frustrated. I'm frustrated with my insurance company and the adjuster and their contractors. I'm being told that they're going to take care of something, and then all of a sudden they put other homeowners and boat owners in harm's way.
I reached out to that insurance company. I'm still waiting to hear back, and FWC tells me that they're still investigating who the responsible party is. Live from Southwest Cape Coral, I'm Gina Tomlinson, NBC2.